Everybody, glad to have you with us this morning. And we're going to start out this morning, abs nice and tight. We're going to take those arms out to the side, lift that right knee. Let's rotate your hands and your foot. Warm up those ankles, warm up those wrists, go the other way. And then put that foot down, roll those shoulders back and down. Let's do the other leg, lift up that left knee and rotate foot and hand. Right, your right knee is slightly bent. Now go the other way. March right, left. I don't know about you, but I need to get warmed up. Just looking outside at this rain and cold, I'm looking forward to getting hot. All right, let's take a big deep breath in. And exhale it. Give me one more. Now roll your shoulders back. Nice big shoulder roll. And then roll forward. March it out wide. All right, we're going to plant these feet. Now I want you to slide your hands halfway down your thighs. Flat back. Round it up. Put your chin to your chest. Hold that. Flat neutral back. Round it up. And last time, flatten your back out and round it up slow and easy. Lower back, middle back, upper back through the neck. All right, hands on your hips, and we're going to tap our toes. Get ready with the right left. Here we go. Really point those toes. Continuing to get those ankles warmed up. Take shoulder back. And backstroke it. Now take your arm across. Reach that arm out there. Bring that arm back up, and we're reaching towards the ceiling. Now give me heel dips. Heels to the floor, bicep curls. Now inner thighs, reach down, touch the instep. Knees front, push it up. Four, three, two, now leg kicks front. Four, three, two, now give me knee side. Lift them up high, really warms up your hips. Abductors. Now give me hamstring curls, pull those arms back and squeeze at the shoulder blades. I feel the knee for eight more. Let's do it. Eight, seven, six, five, four, three, two, and one. All right, take your feet out about hip width apart. And we're going to do some ragdoll squats. And we're going to come down and just kind of sweep the floor and then sweep the ceiling. Two little sweeps on the floor and one on the ceiling. Keep those knees behind your toes as you squat. Last one. All right, march it out. All right, we're going to take our legs out wide, knees and toes are pointed out, and we're going to lunge right and left. So get ready to lunge to your right, and here we go. Punch it, punch it. Get these inner and outer thighs warmed up. And hold it on the right. We'll stretch the left inner thigh muscles. All right, I want you to take your right hand and either just keep it right here and lift up toward the ceiling, or you can slide that hand down to your ankle and lift that arm. Look up your arm. All right, bring it back. Come up straight up. And let's lunge over to the left and hold it right there. Nice deep breathing. All right, same thing. You can either hold that hand here or slide it down to your ankle and lift that right arm, look up that arm. And come on back. I'm just walking on in. Now, when you get about here, I want you to swing your hips forward, back. Take it forward, back. Knee bicep curls and triceps. Swing it forward and back. Running up those hip flexors. All right, now right here, we're going to swing those hips side to side. Use your ab muscles. And relax. All right, walk it in. Shake your legs out really, really good. Lift your knees and grab some water. And then we're going to get a little cardio in. And then the cardio will involve things that are working your core. Okay. So we're going to start out by kicking front. So it's a kick, kick. You can do the arm up overhead if you want a little more cardio. Get ready. Let's go. Kick, kick. So arms are here or here. Use those ab muscles. You're feeling your core working. We're going to do a 45-second interval with each one of these exercises. Get that heart rate up. All right, we're 30 seconds in. I got 15 seconds left to go. Nice, strong arms. Work those arms. Keep those abs nice and tight. Last chip. March it out. Okay, keep it moving. All right, now we're going to take our feet out about hip width apart. We're going to add another squat in. This time we're going to do some windmills. So you can do your squat low, you know, real shallow like this, or you can go deeper, or you can go real deep and touch the floor. Let's go. Really works your core, working your back, getting those legs and arms. All right, now go the other way. Change in the wind direction. Really tight. awesome because that was working your back and your core. Shake those legs out really, really good. Lift your knees. Woo! Shaking it all out. Okay. We're going to go back into that little plie squat position. Doesn't have to be out as wide. We're going to break the ice. Double thumb uppercuts. Punch across. Finish with a football hustle. Everything working your core. All right. Break the ice. Boom. All right, you can keep it right here. You can add hop if you want a little more cardio. Now double time uppercuts. Work those arms. Keep that core tight. Your core is stabilizing you. Nice deep breathing in. Alright, get ready to punch it across. Punch it across. Punch. Strong, control, punches. You're gonna feel this into the obliques like nobody's business. Work it. I love this one. I can really feel this. All right, get ready for that football hustle. Here we go, football hustle. Those feet moving fast. Now bring it in, knees and toes and point it forward. Big flash dance. Out wide again. And bring it back in. And take it out wide again. All right, hopefully that heart rate's coming up. And bring it back in last time. All right, we're going to walk it out. Get some water. Keep those feet moving. We're going to do karate kicks, kicking side to side. Make sure you turn your head toward the kick and punch. Get ready to go. Kick it right. Control the kicks, control the arms. You can spread those fingers out as you punch. So work your fingers if you like. Use those ab muscles. I don't think you have a choice. I think if you're doing this, your abs are kicking in. Alright, here come your last eight, seven, six, five, four, three, two, and one. Alright, shake it all out, lift those knees. Okay, feet are about hip width apart. Now what I want you to do is kind of tip of the hip and bring your arms around. I want you to make a fist and we're going to circle them up. Now keep those abs nice and tight. You can squeeze through those glutes and hamstrings. Alright, slow it down. Go reverse. Fast, faster. Working that lower back by tipping at the hip. Your core is engaged. Getting those arms. Glute muscles are working. And relax. Alright, shake it all out. Alright, take your palms and push them down to the back wall. I mean, down to the floor. Chin on your chest. Alright, now move it all around. Okay, I'm going to slow this music down. I want you to grab one weight. It can be light or heavy. We're going to go through the legs, bicep curl, overhead press. So make your decision on slowing the music down. Okay. All right, I've got a heavy weight. You can get what you like. Okay, Mary Ann join us? Good morning, Mary Ann. All right, feet are about hip width apart. You're going to take that weight. You're going to go through your legs. Make sure you control it all the way through. So go through. You're getting that squat with knees behind your toes, bicep curl, overhead press. All right, we're going to go really slow because I want the muscles to do the work. We don't want momentum going. Keeping those knees behind your toes as you squat. Right there, really works your core as you do that overhead press. Let's do four more. So good. Here comes your last one. All right, shake it all out. Okay, what I want you to do now is grab two light weights. Make sure they're light, or you can use none at all, it's okay. If you're getting a weight, squat things up. Okay, so feet are about hip width apart, your knees are soft, roll your shoulders back and down, and we're gonna, you can either alternate one arm at a time, your palms are facing in, or both at the same time. As you lift, you're gonna feel your core just tighten up. All right, roll those shoulders back and down, abs nice and tight, knees are soft. All right, take it up for two. Up, up, down, and down. Up, up, down, and down. Up, up, down, down, up, up, down, and down. All right, now I want you to lift it up and hold it. Core is working, I feel it. Your knee elbows are slightly bent. Hold it. Hold it, hold it. And relax it. All right, let your chin cut into your chest. All right, rolling those shoulders back and down. You can put these weights down to the side. We will be using some light weights when we do go down to the floor, so put them where you can grab them. All right, I want to do a balance activity right now. So we're going to do an airplane, so take your arms out to the side. That left leg comes forward. You're going to shoot that weight under the left leg and lift the right leg. Now you can put that right toe on the floor if you need extra stability. Keep your abs contracted. Now you're stabilizing you in this position. Breathe deep. Hold for eight more. Eight, seven, six, five, four, three, two. Now very slowly bring that knee out to the front. Very slowly. It's difficult to shift your weight like this and not lose your balance. And relax it. All right, shake those legs out really good. Lift your knees, and let's go to the other side. So right leg is forward. We're going to take those arms out of the side, shift that weight onto that right leg, and lift your left leg out behind you for that airplane. Don't want to get on one right now. We can pretend. Nice deep breathing. Hold for eight more. Eight, seven, six, five, four, three, two, and one. Now very slowly shift that way, bringing that knee to the front, and hold. All right, relax, shake it on and out. Okay, I want you to take your chair. I'm assuming you have your chair nearby since we use them all the time for, and I want you just to put it over here at the end of your mat. When you put your mat down, you're going to need your water. So grab your water, put it where you can grab it, because the rest of the class will be on the floor. And get your mat, put it down. So what you're going to do is put your mat right at the end of your chair. That's out of my way. So my husband hurt his back in November, had a rupture of, not a ruptured disc, what do you call it? Anyway, he had some problems with the disc. So right now we're doing a lot of this stuff on the floor. I'm doing it with him each night so he can strengthen his back and his core, and hopefully won't have any more problems with that. So, since we have this chair here, we're going to use it to begin with. So, I want you just to put your feet on your chair. Come on down. That ain't gonna work. Can't see the screen. Okay, now I want you to tighten up your abs and bring your hands behind your head, elbows out to the sides. We're going to come up for two. Up, up, down, and down. Up, up, down, and down. Up. Up, down, and down. Up, up, down, and down. Up, up, down, and down. All right, we're gonna switch this into singles. Let's go singles. Up, down, up, down, up, down, up, and down. Squeeze those abdominals. Exhale as you lift. Now lift up, hold it. 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Now lift up your left leg. And we're going to reach up toward that left leg. Get ready. And reach. 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 Squeezing as you lift. Continue to exhale as you do the immersion. All right, now other leg. Lift, 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 and relax. All right, just relax for just a couple seconds. Now, if you can, just take your chair and pull it in closer to you. I need to get mine on my mat so it won't slide. Okay. So what we're going to do is put our heels on our chair like so, and we're going to come up. And this is a little bit different from the way we normally do the pelvic tilts and the bridges, obviously, but we're going to work the muscles differently. So lift up, release. So your heels are on your chair. Now, if this really is not your thing, just put your feet on the floor and do it. It adds a little bit of intensity, especially into the hamstring muscles, and you're squeezing those ab muscles as you do this. All right, now I want you to lift up and hold it. 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. All right, come down, and we're gonna pull those knees into our chest just to get a little stretch. We're gonna go right back and finish that up, but I want you to stretch first. All right, just kind of shake those legs out. All right, heels are back on your chair if you're doing that, and lift your hips up. Now we're gonna work the inner thighs, bringing the knees in and out. And here we go. Pull in, out, in, out, in, out, in, out. Squeeze, squeeze. Feel the core working. Yes, it is working. 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. All right, put it down. The hamstring. Yes. All right, bring them in. Bring it in. Hug in. Okay. You can push that nasty little chair out of your way. See, I didn't like you in those exercises. Are we going to turn over to our right side or left side? Let me just say left side because mirror image here. Okay, so I want you to put your left elbow right underneath your shoulder. Make sure it's directly beneath your shoulder. All right, now you've got your legs stacked right here, but what I want you to do is take your right leg and bend it and put your right foot right beside your left knee. Okay, now we're going to lift this left leg straight up toward the ceiling. Here we go. Lift up and down. Up, down. Up, down. Up, down. All right, so you're feeling those obliques working in your core as you lift. Give me eight more. Lift the leg as high as you can. Now we're going to lift up and hold for 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2. Now give me little pulses right here. 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. And relax. All right, shake that leg out. All right, flip it over. All right. So now you have your right elbow right underneath your right shoulder. Your body's in a straight line. Now we're going to take that left leg and put that left foot right beside your right knee. All right, flex that right foot and get ready to lift it. Just waiting on this music. Abs are as tight as you can make them. Lift it up. Lift up and down. Up and down. Flexing that foot, keeping it parallel with the floor and the ceiling, and really squeezing into those inner thighs. 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Now lift up and hold. 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2. Now get those little baby ones right here, right into that inner thigh muscles. And relax it. All right, shake those legs out real good. All right, now we're gonna come up and we're gonna do a V set. So you're gonna be right here. Level one, you're gonna grab your hamstrings and lean back, okay? So that's your level one. Level two, you're gonna let go with your hands. Level three, lift your feet up off the floor. Level four, go into a V. So join me with your level, with what's comfortable for you. Now when I say what's comfortable, I still want you to challenge yourself a little bit, but I don't want you to overdo it. So breathe, make sure you're not, it's easy to hold your breath while you're doing this, but it's nice deep breathing. All right, now I want you to come here and clap your hands, give yourself an ovation, not a standing one because you're sitting, and relax. Oh, okay, wrap those arms underneath your legs and hug them in. Okay, now we're going to come here and take our hands behind our hips, and I want your legs out straight and comfortable on your tush. Okay, I want you to bend your left foot and put it right beside your right knee. And the choice here is to keep your behind on the floor and lift the leg, or lift your behind up off the floor. All right, lift that right leg. Lift, release. Lift, release. Lift, release. So you're bringing that right knee up about level with that left knee. Really working a lot of different muscle groups here. Give me eight more. So you're working your quads on the right leg. You're working your hamstrings on the left. You're working your triceps and arms and your core. Now lift up that right knee, hold it. 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. And release it and shake those arms out. So you're working your wrists. You feel that in your wrists, right? Shake it on out. All right, let's go back to it. Again, your hands are behind your hips, your fingers are pointing forward. Now, if that really bothered you a lot, you can turn your hands out. You won't quite get the tricep work, that's okay. All right, bend that right foot, right knee, and put that right foot right beside your left knee. All right, make your decision. You're either keeping that behind on the floor or you're lifting it up. Hold on 1 second, I want to get towards it when we start. All right, lift it up if you're doing that. Now, left leg lift. Lift, release. Lift, release. Keep those abs in nice and tight. Lifting that left knee up as high as your right knee. Eight more. Three, two, one. Now lift up, hold it. Eight, seven, six, five, four, three, two, and one. Relax it. All right, shake it all out. Okay, I want you to get about the middle of your mat here. Legs are extended out, and you're going to use your hips to walk forward. Okay? Feeling it in your abs, feeling it. You're getting this in your hips too. Walk until you get to the end of your mat, and then you're going to go backwards. Pooching yourself along. I think Debbie's been doing a lot of this since she broke her ankle. And we need to do it. Now we're going back to the center where we started. And you are done with that. Yay. All right, let's grab a sip of water. Here. We're going to do I Dream of Jeannie abs. So put your feet together. Give me those I Dream of Jeannie arms. All right, now your choices here are be here or lean back or to lift your feet up. Take a right, center, left, center, right, center, left, center. Give me a twist. Really working those obliques. And bring it back to center. All right, wrap those arms underneath your legs and give them a big hug. All right, we're going to do another thing for your obliques. All right, put your feet on the floor like so. Knees are together. I want you to glue those knees together because that gives you a little bit of inner thigh work while you're working your abs. All right, so we're going to take those elbows and lock them into your rib cage. Now, your choice here, you can lean back a little bit, is to twist just a little bit, or to twist to touch your elbow to the floor. Awesome for your obliques. But if it bothers your lower back, I want you just to be up here and you can just twist some more like we do with these I Dream of Jeannie abs. All right, here we go, right, left. Take your right, center, left, center, right, center, left, center, right, center, left, center, right, center, left. Eight more. Eight, seven, six, five, four, three, two, and one, and relax. All right, wrap those arms up and underneath your legs again, and hug them. All right, before we get down to the floor, I want you to get those light weights. If you want to use them, again, you don't have to use them. All right, and we're going to come down to the floor. Get down as slowly as you can. All right, now I want you to take your feet up toward the ceiling. Grab your weights. Okay, now we're going to do something for your chest and abs at the same time, multitasking. So what we're going to do is bring those arms out. Your arms are going to be almost straight. Elbows stop just above the floor. Down for two. Down, down, up, and up. So this is chest wide. If you want to add intensity, lift your hips up slow, up off the floor a little bit. Lift your shoulders up off the floor a little bit. Two down, 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 up, and up, down, down, up, and up, and down, down, up, and up, down, down, up. Now take it down and hold it. Elbows just above the floor, hold it right here. Now give me little circles, just little tiny circles with your arms. Working on those chest muscles, arms. Go the other way with those circles. All right, now we're gonna bring, what I want you to do is bend to the elbow, bring your weight to your chest, and then open it back out. So it's like you're closing the doors, your French doors, and then you're opening them back up. So close, if you need a break with your head, go ahead and take that. You don't wanna stress out your neck. Slow and control. All right, your last one. Now I want you to take your weights and face your palms towards your feet. Now lift your hips slightly up off the floor, your shoulders up, and let's lift, release. You can do this with that, with or without weight. Lift and squeeze those abs. Exhale as you lift. Exhale! Exhale. All right, now lift up and hold. 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. And relax it. Okay, so you can make those weights and put them out of your way. You will not need those again during this class. So put them there. All right, shake your arms out a little bit. Wide them side to side. Okay, we are going to take your left foot, put it flat on the floor, right leg goes up to the ceiling. Hands behind your head, elbows out to the side. You see me kind of moving around. I'm just trying to get comfortable on my back, and you should too, because we don't want that distraction while we're working our abs. All right, keep your left foot on the floor, lift it up, and let's do big lassos with that right leg. Make it big. All right, now you're going to go the other way. All right, relax, put those feet on the floor, get comfortable on your back one more time. Lift that left leg up, shoulders up, lift that right foot if you want to. And just hold it here. I'm going to get on the beat because it helps me count when we won't do 2 minutes. All right, here we go. Big lasso with that left leg. All right, go the other way. And relax. All right. Lift yourself up and come small the back one more time. All right, now we're going to take that right ankle below the left knee. Make sure you're not resting your foot, your leg, on top of that kneecap. All right, hands behind your head. We're going to lift the left shoulder to the right knee. Here we go. Up, up, down, and down. Now I want you to keep your left elbow out of your peripheral vision. Up, up, down, and down, up, and up, and down, and down. Keep going. Up, up, down, down, squeezing into the right obliques. Up,
up, down, and down, and up, and up, and down. Now take it up and hold it. Hold it right there. Hold it, hold it. Breathing nice and deep. All right, give me a little pulses here. Right into the right oblique. Squeeze, squeeze. Give me eight more. Eight, seven, six, five, four, three, two, and one. Relax it down. Okay, we're gonna keep this figure four position with the legs. And what we're gonna do is do a reverse curl. So lifting the shoulders up, and we're gonna reverse curl and lift that lift the hips up on the floor. If you can't lift the hips, just do this number. Okay, get ready, and here we go. If you can, lift your hips up off the floor, control it. All right, now bring it up and hold it. Hold that position. Squeezing those ab muscles, shoulders up, hips up slightly, and relax. All right, shake those legs out real good. All right, now we're going to take that left ankle, bring it below the right knee, and we're going to lift our right shoulder up toward the left knee. So lead with the shoulder, keep the elbow out of the way, up for two. Up, up, down, and down. Up, up, down, and down. Up, up, down, down, up, up. Keep it coming. Four more. Up, up, down, down, up, up. Squeezing the left side oblique. Now lift up, hold. Eight, seven, six, five, four, three, two. Now little pulses. Lift, 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 and lift. Relax it. All right. I think we need a sip of water. So grab one hand, one leg, and just roll up. Or grab both legs, roll up, and get some water. Oh my goodness, the time is flying. It's already 11:15. My goodness. Okay. Okay. Come back down. I want you to come down as slow as you can. Make those abs do that work. All right, now we're going to take our arms out to the side, straight out to the side. Lift your legs up towards the ceiling. Now your option here is to keep your head on the floor or lift it up, lifting those shoulders slightly up. We're going to take those legs over to the right, and then I want you to stop when you feel your right obliques working. Breathing in deep. All right, come on back center and over to the left, and you're going to stop when you feel the left obliques holding you up. They are working. All right, bring it back center and come down here. All right. Put your hands down beside your hips or right underneath your behind if you like. And we're going to drop one leg at a time. Or you can get those scissors going. So you choose. Modify any way you need to. All right, put those feet down. All right, we're gonna do one more thing, and then we're gonna roll it over to the belly and get some back work in. So I want you to bring the soles of your feet together and let your knees kind of hang open. Hands behind your head, elbows out to the side, lift your shoulders up, and bring those knees in, out, in, out, in, out, in, out. Squeeze those knees together. Squeezing your abs. And pull those knees in and relax. All right, now we're gonna roll over to the belly. All right, we're gonna start out with a plank. So you can either, there are lots of ways to do a plank. So you can be down on your forearms, elbows need to be right underneath your shoulders, and then come up on your toes and make your body in a straight line. You can drop your knees in this position. You can also be up here with your hands underneath your shoulders and be like this, or you can be like that. All right, so lots of different ways to do them. Get in your position and hold it. Squeeze those abs. Just keep them contracted. This is the beauty of this exercise. You really don't need to do anything but just this, and your abs are working. Squeeze them in. All right, now let's touch the knees to the floor. Touch, 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 touch. Try not to lose your form. You need that straight line with your body. All right, now touch both knees and just hold it. And relax it. Woo! Okay, now we're gonna work. We've done a lot of things for abs, so we're gonna do back stuff because it's your opposing muscles. We need to keep them equally strong. Okay, we're gonna start out. All I want you to do is take your right arm forward, lift your left leg up off the floor, and try to get that knee up off the floor, and squeeze through the left side glute muscles. You are working your lower back right here. Hold it. All right, bring it in, and we're gonna switch. Left arm out, lift that right leg up, and squeeze through the right side glute muscles. Try to get your right knee up off the floor. All right, relax it. Roll your hips side to side. Okay, now we're gonna do Superman. If you don't want to do the full Superman, you're either going to keep your, let's just keep your feet on the floor, okay? So lift your arms up off the floor and lift your feet up off the floor if you want to do that. Now, but like I said, they can be here with your feet on the floor. Now, if you get your knees up off the floor, it's a lot harder. Squeezing through those glutes, you're feeling this in the lower back, into the upper back because you've lifted your arms up. Hold it, hold it, and relax it. All right, roll your hips side to side, releasing the spine. Okay, now we're gonna do the same thing like we just did with Superman. Keep your feet on the floor. We're gonna do breaststroke, okay? So you can lift your feet up or keep them on the floor. This is getting into your upper part of your back. Make it strong. You want to really feel it into those shoulder blades. All right, relax it. All right, roll those hips side to side. All right, now stack your hands one on top of the other, put the forehead on top of your hands. And we're gonna lift our feet up and flutter kick. Now you can keep your knees on the floor. If you lift them up, lift the knees up, it's gonna be harder. All right, relax it. Roll those hips side to side. All right, we're gonna do the same thing. Lift those feet up and crisscross. So bend your knees, one leg on top and then the other. If you can get those knees up off the floor, wonderful. If not, it's okay. Getting some quadricep and hamstring work in here. Alright, relax it, roll those hips side to side. Alright, now we're gonna do back extensions.
So back extensions are here, or they're here with the legs up.
Or if you need a little extra help, put your hands down to the side and look this way. Alright, any way you do it, you're gonna strengthen the back.
So it's all good. Alright, get ready and lift.
Lift,
release.
Lift high enough that you feel the lower back muscles working. Now lift up, hold
for 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1.
Take your arms down to roll pose. All right, we're gonna squeeze those shoulder blades together. All right, here we go.
Squeeze,
squeeze. Make it nice and strong. Let's try 8 more. If you're done, you're done. That's okay. 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. And relax. Alright, roll those hips side to side. Alright, we're going to take our hands down beside our chest. Come up into a cobra. Keep your head in alignment with your spine. Abs are nice and tight. Now we're going to sit back on your heels in a child's pose. And as you do this, you're going to go, oh, that feels so good in my lower back. All right, I want you to stretch your arms way out in front of you. And then digging your hands into the mat, I want you to pull your elbows, bend your elbows, pull your elbows back. Feel that lift through your chest. All right, now come up on your hands and knees and round to the back. Another aww moment. All right, flat neutral back. Round up. Chin on your chest. Flat neutral. One more time. Round up. And flat neutral. Let's take that right ball of your foot to the floor. Press your right heel toward the floor. Get that good stretch of the calf muscles. Now drop your right knee. Just touch it to the mat. Don't put any weight on it. All right, switch those legs. Left ball of your foot to the floor, pressing that heel into the floor. All right, drop that left knee and just touch it to the mat. All right, now turn over to your back and go down slowly to your back. We put on some nice slow music for us to relax to. Lift up your arms above your head, point your toes. I feel so much better after I work out. I hope you do as well. It just makes me feel great. All right, reach up with the right hand, point your right toes, stretch the right obliques. All right, now reach up with the left hand, point your left toes, stretch the left obliques. Alright, relax that. Bring your knees in one at a time. Hug underneath your legs. Nice deep breathing. Inhaling through the nose, exhaling through the mouth. Let's take those knees over to the left and turn your head, your arms to the right. And take your right knee and press it towards your left knee. Control your legs up and over to the right and turn your head and your arms to the left. Now press your left knee toward your right knee. Control your legs up into the center. Put your feet flat on the floor. Get comfortable on your back. Right leg is up to the ceiling. Grab your leg anywhere you want to and gently pull the leg toward your chest. Press your heel higher than your toes and feel that stretch down the back of your leg. All right, we're going to pull that leg slightly closer and straighten the knee out just a little bit more. Keep that heel higher than your toes so you really feel that stretch. All right, bending your knee, we're going to bring that right ankle below that left knee. Take your right hand and press your right leg away from you until you feel the stretch with your right hip. All right, now keeping this figure four position, bring that left knee into your chest. Feel this through the right side glute muscles. Pull it in closer. Now put your left foot flat on the floor, right foot flat, get comfortable on your back. Left leg goes up to the ceiling, push that heel higher than your toes, gently pull the leg toward your chest. Now straighten out that left knee a little bit more, pull the leg a little bit closer to your chest. Bring your left ankle below the right knee and take your left hand, press that left leg away from you to feel through the left hip. Keeping this position with the legs, bring the right knee into your chest. Feel through the left glute muscles. Pull it in closer. I release, bring the legs into your chest and roll up. Let's take that right leg out to the side, your left leg's in front. You're going to reach with your right hand toward your ankle or your toes. Left arm comes up over your head, lean into it. Releasing that, we're going to bring the soles of your feet together. Now press your knees towards the floor. Keep it here, but if you want more intensity with it, lean over your legs. Right leg's going to be right in front. Reach with your left hand towards your ankle or your shoe, your toes. Right arm comes up over your head. Lean into that stretch.
It's amazing how you can speak right.
All right, release that. We're going to cross the ankles. Sit up nice and tall. Scoot back a little bit. Take a big deep breath in, and then as you exhale, just lean over your legs to get a good stretch of the hips and lower back. Now arms go over your right knee, and then press your left arm out farther. Get a good stretch of those left obliques. And bring it back center. Arms go over that left knee and press your right arm out just a little bit farther. Bring it back center. Sit up nice and tall, hands beside your hips, and drop your chin to your chest, stretch the back of your neck. Now bring the right ear toward the right shoulder. Let that right arm just kind of hang out. And then take your left palm and press your left palm into the floor.
All day long I can hear.
Bring your chin to your chest. Now Now bring the left ear to the left shoulder. Let that left arm just hang and press your right palm into the floor. And come back chin to your chest. Now bring your right hand above your left knee. Press your left shoulder back. Look down that shoulder. Switch up. Left hand above the right knee. Press your right shoulder back. Look down the shoulder. Bring it back center. Interlace your fingers. Stretch your arms out in front of you. Round your back. And then put the hands on the lower part of your back and squeeze your shoulder blades together at the end of the chest. All right, right palm to the ceiling. Gently pull the fingertips back. We didn't actually work out our biceps today, but they got work doing other things. So we'll stretch it out. All right, bring that right arm up and gently pull the elbow back. Get the triceps on the right side. Switch your elbows, getting the left triceps. Now bring that left palm to the ceiling. Gently pull the fingertips back. Almost there, y'all. I'm sorry I'm going over, but we started late today. All right, let's step forward. And hands on the floor and roll back. Let's get that stretch to your feet. Pressing those heels towards the floor, rolling back on the balls of your feet. And keeping your hands on the floor, start straightening out your knees. Release those hands, roll it up through the back into the shoulders. Take a step out to the side, give me a big old deep breath in. And exhale